So where are we going next? Is it libunistring? No. Something here would have been needing GCC. I can't remember what it was now. Let's start up here. Right, this must be a good place to continue actually. I can't remember what the GCC was for now. Guess we'll come back to it, whatever it was. Yeah, not to worry. This might be a good path to follow. We've got libunistring. I'll reinstall that once TextLive is installed. Libatomic Ops hasn't got dependencies. Both of these are needed for, sorry, Libatomic Ops is needed for GC. Guile needs GC and libunistring, so that will then build. We've got GDB installed mostly, so that will enable us to install Rust C, which I think has got. I still need curl and libssh. Let's have a look at these two. And that one's got a few dependencies. Which I think that's mostly complete. Let's go to dbus, GCR, GPG. Yeah, it's a case of knowing where to jump in here. System, well, that's waiting to be rebuilt, isn't it? So Gnome, dbus, GCR. Ah, right, that one needed Fortran. Is that the one we need to go for next? Yeah, G4tran, sorry. So, yeah, I'm going to install this one next because it's effectively got the dependencies fulfilled. Libgcrypt. GGR, so that'll have to be reinstalled for TextLive. Alright, so this is just for alternative. So if you're interested in the extra documentation, which possibly would be, it depends on how important this package is to you, then you'd need to install it TextLive first. I think TextLive's quite onerous, wasn't it? TextLive. Yes, there's a lot there. So I might mark that down to reinstall. So, yeah, these go back to fulfilling. What was it fulfilling? Is it this here? Gnome keyring for Falkon, that's right. So we can get these done. So let's deal with these this few then. So let me start by tidying up our previous build. And And we'll install GPG error next. Let's have a look at the configuration. There's nothing other than what's stated there. Okay, let's run some tests. All passed. And now let's, become the root and install the package. And that's done. So chapter 9, GPG error. And then we go to Pth. So don't add the enable pthread parameter in to the config command below, else you'll overwrite the pthread library and interface header installed by the glibc package in LFS. Okay, so we'll just copy and paste what we've got here. That's all done, as it says make test to test, so I should do that now. And that looks like that's a pass. So let's install it. And that's complete. So again, chapter 9, and it's called Pth. I'll shut that down, but just check I haven't got duplicates of these. So Pth is there only once, and libgpg error is 2, libgpg error, yep, that's fine. So now we go to libgcrypt. I'm better just check this one's not duplicated. No, it doesn't look like it. So depending on, I guess how much time I've got left to complete this, depending on how slow the rest of the build is, for the moment I'll mark this up as rebuild, to get the text live, and I'll rebuild it for the extra documentation so you can see that happening. But for now I'll build it without. We've got all the dependencies, the required dependency in particular. So libgcrypt saves that. Okay, install the following commands. So configure, WizCompat enables LibCap2 support, but it breaks crypt setup. So I guess that's probably a good idea to leave out. So just copy this. Oh, so it has built documentation in HTML and plain text format. So yeah, I might just leave it. At least there is some documentation. But if you do require it in those alternative formats, then it would need to be rebuilt after TextLive. Okay, that's built, so it's make check to test the results. Okay, all done, all passed. So let's install now with these commands here. And if you've installed the extra document or built the extra documentation, that command there needs to be run as well. So we can tidy that one up and mark it off, libgcrypt. And close the tab down. Move on to libxslt. So I think, yes, we just needed libgcrypt for this. Everything else should be installed. So a quick look, libxml2's there, docbookxsl, and xml, yep. So libxslt, yep, it's not there, so... Save that. And start the build with these commands here. Some other commands. Without Python, disables XSLT Python module since it does not support Python 3. If you wish to enable this module, make sure Python 2 libxml 2 module is installed and remove this parameter. So I'll just leave that in, I think, as it is. I think Python 2 is only installed to satisfy certain packages. It's not in the book for any other reason. Okay, it says a main page is glitched that's been shipped. And if the recommended dependencies are installed, we can run this command. So we've done that. This should work. It seems to have done. Make check to test it. Okay, that's done, so let's now install it, and that's that job done. Okay, so it's chapter 9 again, libxslt. So now on to Gnome keyring. Right, so we've got some dependencies here that still need to be built. So we've done libxslt, we've done GNU PG. Let's open another tab. That's chapter 4. Right, no, we haven't done that one yet. Oh yeah, that's got a few dependencies. That's further down, isn't it? So we've done these two now. We've got Linux PAM. I think GCR, Dbus and GNU PG need to be done. So I think we need to go to the back end of this list. Take a look at these again. So there's a few dependencies there. GCR's got a few dependencies. Here's the GNU PG. Yes, yeah, so there's a few dependencies here. Right, so this one needs just GNU PG. So I'm wondering if it's worth going down this route now. Oh, crikey, there's a load more here. Look at this one again. Right, yes, there's lots to do still to pick out. Let's go to the back end again. The best thing to do is just start to pick these off. So e-login D, I think I did that one. Yeah, that's been installed. Let's find out. Oh yeah, these have got circuit dependency, haven't they? So it says first build without them, then again after both packages are installed. So I'm not even sure if I've built Dbus with those packages installed, so I think I will go down this route now. Linux PAM we've got these two, we've got that one now to build the man pages. Let's look at Polkit. It needs glib and JS78. Right. to take a look and see what glib needs. So we've got dbus of sorts, certainly is installed. TDK talks about some tests, but there's a circular dependency. And sysprof, right, so I think I'll... Let's do PCRE next. Let's do this a bit at a time, I think. Right, yeah, so let's do PCRE. Save. Right, has that already been built then? So a quick way to find out is, have we got PCRE grep, which is a tool, and we have. So that has been built. I'm going to check that in my list. Yes, it has. In fact, both PCREs have been built, so that's good. So back to glib. We've got dbus.gtk.doc, build the API documentation, not interested in that. Glib networking for some tests, but it's a circular dependency. Well, we've got glib installed, so we could install glib networking. I'm just reinstalling glib for any other functionality that might be available. So let's go to GNU TLS next. That requires nettle libtesn. We've done that one, I think, for something else. No, we haven't. I thought we'd done that one. So let's do libtesn. GTK doc. So that's for API documentation. So, right, we can build this one next. Oh, hang on. We have got it. I thought we did have. Yeah, there it is. Okay, and again, I'm just going to check this, make sure I haven't forgotten it. Yep, there it is marked off, so that's good. So these are obviously ones that I've built on the Falkon that was on my system that I'm using to record this. So let's look at P11kit, which is why the link was still blue. So it looks like we've got P11kit as well. So that actually needs our libxslt. We've just built that, and I'm not sure we've got NSS. So this is chapter 4, security. Right, I haven't got a note to rebuild it. NSS. Yes, that's been built as well. So I'm going to click on that link just to change the colour of it, give you an indication I have actually done. And NSPR we've done as well. NSPR. Where is that one? Yeah, that's done as well. So I'll click on that. Okay, so we can get rid of that one. That one. That one can go. So then, Doxygen, probably GTK doc as well. Yeah, I don't think we need those two. Guile, I'm sure we've done that now, or it's up to be built. Right, we haven't done it, but it's somewhere here to be built. There it is there. So let's shift this right to the end. I'm not sure if I can do it here, actually. No, I can't. So GC we've got to build. Let's get rid of that from there. Guile. GC requires libatomic ops. Right, so let's do this one next then. Oops. So there's nothing special to add to the configure command there, so we'll run it and build. That's done. Make check to run the tests. And install it. And that's done. So libatomic ops, mark that one off. Close it down. And we can build GC now. Okay, so that means that this probably goes to a web page or the file's not found, something like that. So let's open. Alright, okay, so maybe it's a script of some sort. Let's save it again. Not the gzip format. Tar archive. Oh, how strange. Let's try saving it once more. So it's about 4.5 meg. So it's not in gzip format. So let's convert it straight to a tar, because that's what it's told us it is. Oops. Interesting. So it's not been compressed. Oh yes, it looks like it should be 1.1 meg, and it's actually 4.5 meg. So that's interesting. I can't check the MD5 sum because it's obviously a different file. So that's interesting. What I might do, because I'm not sure about what's happened here, is I'm going to delete that directory, delete the tar file, and I'm actually going to look for this file on the internet. Search for it. Now, if you've heard my videos before, you'll know I've mentioned the Oregon State University has got an FTP server with all these files on, so I'll try and type Oregon in. And looks like this would be a good link here. Come up. Up again. And we can go into 11.0. and it's GC, so under G. And you can see there's GC there, and it's 1.1 meg, so I'm going to save this copy here. Seems to have downloaded. I'm actually going to go back to the parent here and shift this all the way back to the beginning. It'll be a useful tab to keep open. I'm actually going to pin it there. As well. So if I now go back to GC, now I'm going to run MD5 sum on GC and just eyeball that with the number that's here, and yes, it matches. So I know definitely that I've got the right file now and that it's not been tampered with. Probably nothing wrong with the other one. Maybe, you know, something's happened, they've recompiled it. Maybe. But, what am I doing? That's because I'm typing and talking at the same time. But it's best to be sure, especially if you're unsure. So, what have we got here? Right, okay, so there's nothing extra that they offer here. They just explain existing configuration options that I've used. So I'll configure and make. And that's built, so let's run the tests. Okay, and now we'll install the package. And that's done. Let's just check there's no configuration to do. No. So GC under chapter 13. That's now complete. And we move on to Guile. So GDB is only runtime dependencies. We've got everything else installed. So save link as. What happened there? Oh, it's still saving, wasn't it? It seems that if it's still saving, it takes focus on the download manager when it's completed. So there's a fix here for glibc. And install it. There's no more command explanations, so let's just put this in. Okay, that's done. And let's tidy up. And I'll mark that off, chapter 13. Guile. So that's complete. Shut down the tab.